Hey, good afternoon, everybody. I've been thinking about sometimes back in the late 1970s, because that was the time when I came to Christ, became a Christian. It was 1978. But I especially think back to 1976, a couple of years before that time. I was in Kenai, Alaska. I was living in a little kind of older two-bedroom mobile home, construction trailer that the boss at a job let me stay at. And I remember hitting the bottom right about that time. I was about age 25, and my life was really kind of going downhill fast. I had failure on a number of fronts. And I guess I kind of think of myself at that time of having achieved a degree called the EF degree. I was an expert failure. So I don't know how much time you spend just looking back sometimes. Some of us that have been a Christian a long time, maybe you don't recall the feeling of what it was like to be lost very clearly sometimes. And man, I'll tell you, I picked up a cast iron skillet one time in that kitchen in that little old trailer living there by myself and just skipped it across the floor and it kind of just smacked into the bottom cabinet there by the sink. And I remember thinking at that time, if this was what life was about, you could have it. Life had gotten that depressing for me after a number of failures. So it was a real short time after that I began to meet Christian men, older guys, and they reached out to me in one way or another and just showed love to me, showed kindness to me. One invited me over to his house. I got to experience what it was like to have a home and a family and a couple kids and a peaceful relationship. And because he knew Christ. And another older gentleman one time, he must have been praying for me. He told me, he looked at me, he said, "Hey son, someday you're going to play that guitar for the Lord." And I wasn't even a Christian at the time. Anyway, I'm thankful. I'm really thankful that these men cared enough about a lost person like me to reach out to me with the good news of Jesus's love, Jesus's forgiveness. I mean, seeds were planted that have grown and just have just literally changed my life for the last 42 years, 43 years now. So I thank God. The Bible says Jesus came to seek and to save that which was lost. And boy, I was as lost as they come. I'm so thankful God cared for me and sent people to reach out to me. So I want to pray for us all after I sing this little song. This is by Steve Green. And I don't know, it's most of the songs that I know are older now, but I've never lost my love for the message of this song by Steve Green. And it's called "People Need the Lord." I can see it in their eyes. Empty people filled with care, headed who knows where. On they go through private pain, living fear to fear. Laughter hides their silent cry. Jesus hears. People need the Lord. People need the Lord. At the end of broken dreams, He's the open door. People need the Lord. Lord, when will we realize people need the Lord? We are called to take His light. a world where wrong seems right. What could be too great a cost for sharing life with one who's lost? Through his love, our hearts can feel all the grief they bear. They must hear the words of life that only we can share. People need the Lord. People need the Lord. At the end of broken dreams, he's the open door. People need the Lord. People need the Lord. When will we realize that we must give our lives for people? Need the Lord. People need the Lord. Yes, they do. I did. I still do. I thank God that he came into my life. He radically changed my life. He still is changing it. You know, the Bible says that Jesus looked out on the multitudes. He saw them as like sheep having no shepherd. And he told his disciples, he said, the harvest is great, but the laborers are few. And you know, I want to conclude this little video today just by praying for you, for me, that God would help us to see people through his eyes. You know, I believe it's in Psalms where the Bible says, I will instruct you and teach you in the way which you shall go, and I will guide you with my eye. He wants us to be able to see people the way he does, no matter who they are, no matter where they come from, what they look like. Doesn't matter. But he loves the world. He loves people. He wants them to know they can be reconciled to God through Jesus Christ, through simple faith in Jesus Christ and confessing their sins, asking his forgiveness, and receiving him as Lord. They can be adopted into the family of God. I've always liked Romans 8:15. The Bible says, you have not received a spirit bondage again to fear, but you've received a spirit of adoption whereby we cry, Abba, Father. You know, God is after us. You know why? Because he wants to adopt us. He wants us to place our trust in Jesus and be brought into his forever family. I believe most all of you are in there already, but let's ask God to help us to see the ones that are still on the outside and care enough about them to reach out. I was 4,000 miles from family and friends, totally alone. I was at kind of the end of my rope. And I'm glad God sent people to me to reach out and rescue me. I was lost and I've been found. God, I pray for each of us that we would see the people around us the way that you do. Help us to know, Lord, that being lost really is being lost. We don't know the way. We don't have the way. We can't know the way, and we're in darkness until we come to you, Lord. So I pray that you would give us your love for people that we are near and around and sent to. Lord, help us not to walk on by, but just to hear when you are telling us, hey, stop, pay attention to this one or that one. Lord, just use us, I pray. I pray you'd raise up laborers for your harvest. And thank you again for all those that are reaching out to the lost. Lord, they're all around us. They may have a smile on their face, but if they don't know you, they are lost. So we pray, Lord, send us, prepare us, send us, give us your love. Help us to see them the way you do. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. God bless you all. Amen. He that winneth souls is wise, the Bible says. Jesus said, follow me, I'll make you fishers of men. See you next time.